Ahava and blessings. Happy Wednesday. We are officially in Mercury retrograde. This is a very, it's a very challenging time for many of us. A lot of us have been conditioned to fear these retrogrades, particularly when Mercury goes retrograde, which is the planet that goes retrograde 4 times a year. Mercury retrogrades are not a time to be fearful. This is not really a time to kind of go into panic or anxiety or fear. That is counterintuitive to what actually this energy is supposed to be doing. So Mercury is the planet of communication. It rules technology. It rules travel. Mercury is Hermes. He is the messenger of the gods, the one that can easily, and actually he's one of the few people, Hecate is the other one, who can shift between realms. So he travels between the realm of the physical and the unseen, the heavenly celestial realms. So you can see why Mercury is the god of communication, of travel, of technology. No pulling punches with that one. Aries is the first sign of the Western Zodiac. It is a fire sign. It is all about getting things done, movement, forward motion, momentum, kind of doesn't give up as to how things are going to get done. They just do it. It is a very fiery energy, and this is a good thing. However, when Mercury is retrograde, that means that the planet is, from our perspective on Earth, looks like it's going backwards. And so this is really a time to slow down. It is a time for introspection. This retrograde is conjunct the North Node, Chiron. So the North Node is all about our mission, our purpose, the fulfillment of our soul contract. And what is your soul contract? Your soul contract is, I know it kind of sounds kind of very firm, and in a lot of ways it is. Your soul contract is simply the agreements that you made when you decided to incarnate into this physical form, to play this earth game of ascension, of experiencing the separation and the duality of this world, which for many of us is very different than what our soul is used to. So Dolores Cannon said this very well. She said that only the bravest souls signed up for this earth journey, because it is not a picnic. There are so many other realms where it's so much easier and it's blissful and it's peaceful, but it's a trade-off. Because the ability for our soul to expand and experience and grow is limited because of the lack of duality, because of the lack of differing experiences. That makes sense? I hope that makes sense. If it doesn't, just comment below and let me know. So Mercury retrogrades are a time to go within. They're a time to slow down. They're a time to really align, to review, to reassess, to reconfigure, to re-envision what it is that you are creating. Because remember, every moment, with every thought, every word, we are emitting a frequency into the world that puts us in vibratory harmony with certain experiences. So let's say you are a person that is always riddled with worry, with doubt, with guilt, with anxiety. Because of frequency, like attracts like, you're gonna attract circumstances to make you worry, to make you doubtful, to make you fearful. However, when we can align with our heart and truly align with our soul, and your soul is infinite, your soul is an aspect of the divine essence, source consciousness. consciousness, God, goddess. We use so many words to describe this infinite nature that is creation, that is this consciousness that we are a part of. All of creation is a part of this. And we entered into agreements to experience certain things. We did not know what we were going to do or how we were going to respond to those challenges, but we did enter into agreements to experience certain things. So for me, probably because my natal Mercury is retrograde in my natal chart, for me, Mercury retrogrades are normally very easy. I don't usually feel them because I'm always in this space of every once in a while, I reassess, I re-envision, I reconfigure, and I change. However, this one, I started feeling during the shadow phase, and it started feeling like time was slowing down. I was just like, wait, it's only Monday? I thought it was Thursday. It really felt like everything was slowing down and nothing was moving forward. And it really got me back into what I tell my clients, what I tell you guys, what I tell the people that come to my workshops. It got me back to the home space that I begin from with everything, which is coming back to my heart, coming back into alignment, coming back into receiving the wisdom from my soul, receiving the light, and allowing myself to trust and have faith. This is this Mercury retrograde is at 27 degrees, so that's the number 9. 9 is endings. It's the closing of chapters, of cycles. It's a new beginning. You are going into a new phase, a new evolution, a new upgrade. And it all has to do with your mission. It all is aligning you with your purpose, with your soul essence, with your the true authentic expression that your soul chose to embody and disseminate and radiate into the world. So it's a very powerful time. However, most of us are very hard on ourselves. If we don't think we're doing things right, we tend to judge ourselves, we tend to guilt trip ourselves, we tend to put more blocks up instead of liberating ourselves. And so, I'm going to share a beautiful mantra in Aramaic that I found very helpful. And it speaks of, so Ahava, and you will probably, if you follow me, you hear me say Ahava many times. Ahava means love, but it's more than love. Ahava is, it truly means something along the line of more like love and service. It's an action. It's a commitment. It's a commitment to embodying the frequency of love and sharing that frequency and moving from that heart-centered space. Rachamin, Ahava. Rachamin, compassion. Especially during these times, compassion is something that we often are told to have, but we often don't give it to ourselves. We often hold back. We think it might make us look weak. But compassion is really, it's part of love. It goes hand in hand with the concept of love and of self-love. And of acceptance and of the next word, which is Chesed, which is mercy and loving kindness. This one, like Rachamin, can be challenging as well because we are often very critical, we have high expectations, and we tend to judge ourselves and others oftentimes very harshly. Soul essence, to knowing that we are love, all aspects. our body, from the earth, from one another. And that truly is what Yeshua, when he spoke of sin, that is what he meant. It is anything that separates us from our own infinite selves, from our connection with the divine, with God, Goddess. So having compassion, loving kindness, mercy, Chesed, is very important in our embodiment of our soul. And Shalom, which in Aramaic is Shlama, I think you may have seen the video where I sing Shlama. Shalom, Shlama, it is translated as peace, but it means something deeper. It means oneness, wholeness, completeness, unity. And Inana Noohra, the Alma, I am the light of the soul. And Inana Noohra, Inana really, when they spoke of healing, healing was a collective action. It wasn't just about the physical, just the one person. It was about the relationship between them and the community, and them and the divine. All of these aspects that are seemingly disparate and separate were one. So it really was important to embody and embrace this healing frequency, establish it and ground it in the body, and from there move forward and go back to your village, go back to your life, but only after a period of being away, so that the projections of other people would not cause you to go back to the way you were in an unhealed state. This is why you will often hear me speak of the importance of grounding, of integrating, of embodying, because we have the ability to access higher frequencies and to receive downloads. We absolutely do. However, if we cannot integrate these and make these a part of ourselves, of our day-to-day lived experience, then in many ways it's kind of useless, because we're not integrating the wisdom. We're not actually using it to expand and ground and level up and be that light, be that example for others. So without further ado, Ahava, Rachamin, Chesed, Shalom, Inana Noohra. Oh. into our heart to support us in activating the frequencies of love, of kindness, of mercy, of loving compassion, of forgiveness, and of unity, of oneness, of peace. And anchoring, trusting that we are the light of the world. Inana Noohra, the Alma. And as I was finishing that chant, a beautiful yellow butterfly just flew by the window. And butterflies are a symbol of transformation. And if you know how a butterfly turns from a caterpillar, which is going into the butterfly, my tattoo is all about that, all about transformation. The caterpillar creates a cocoon for itself, and it allows itself to be emulsified, to be rendered into nothing but goo, to be reconfigured, transmuted, alchemized into the butterfly. And this is the process that we are undergoing now. So have faith, don't give up. These energies are working for you. We just have to open ourselves to receive. If you have any questions, if you enjoyed this, please comment, share, follow, subscribe, all things. I hope that you receive this and blessings on this Mercury retrograde. Ahava. I'll see you in my next video.